Hey guys,
my name is Kuyanche, and welcome to episode 20 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about automatic ore generation using X and Hilo, and in this episode we'll start covering the ins and outs of the Logistics Firewall Pipe. So let's get started. The Logistics Firewall Pipe functions pretty much the same as a firewall on your computer, as in you're able to specify what can go through and from what site. So for this demonstration, I got myself two builds set up, pretty much to show you guys the functionality of the Logistics Firewall Pipe. So as you can see, of course, I got myself a Logistics Power Junction, two chests with a Logistics Chassis Mark II pipe set up to it, with a Provider Module Mark II and a Polymorphic Animacy Module, and on either side, a Request Logistics Pipe. In the middle of this, I got myself a Logistics Firewall, which if I right-click with a wrench, you can see is able to be configured. In this, you can set the filtered items that are being either allowed or blocked. So this is a 6x6 whitelist or blacklist field. Pretty much if it's set to blocked, any items that you put in here will not be allowed to go through this Logistics Firewall Pipe. Providing, which means that Logistics Provider Pipes will not be allowed to get items through this firewall. Crafting, so that is something I will show in a minute. Sorting, again, pretty self-explanatory. And power flow, which pretty much means that you can't supply power through the Logistics Firewall Pipe, which is what I will show you guys first. So, because it is set to allowed, you can see that this entire thing has no trouble whatsoever. As you can see, no red outlines or whatever, seems to be all powered up. If I were to set the power flow to being blocked, as you can see, this entire side of the network, including the Logistics Firewall Pipe itself, will stop getting power, pretty much meaning that this entire side of the network is no longer connected. Pretty useful if you can figure out how to actually implement it into your own world. Pretty cool. Then the reason why I made this first setup is to show you guys the filtered items that are allowed. So if I would set it to filtered items are allowed, pretty much only, pretty much nothing would be allowed to go through this pipe because I didn't configure any items. So as you can see, in this crystal chest I got myself a stack of red stained clay, and in this one, a stack of yellow stained clay. On this request logistics pipe, because it is on this side of the network, it can only accept or retrieve items that are also on the same side of the network, because I set it to only allow items that are filtered that can go through here, and of course I didn't configure anything. So as you can see, this request logistics pipe is only able to actually request the red stained clay that is currently in this crystal chest. It does not have access to this crystal chest. And the same way the other way around, because of the request logistics pipe is only able to get items from this crystal chest, because it's only on this side of the firewall pipe. So as you can see, this one can only get yellow stained clay, and this one can only get red stained clay. But now it gets a little bit tricky. Let's say you want this one to only be allowed to get red stained clay, but you want this one to be able to get both. That is where the actual whitelisting comes in. So if I were to say filtered items are allowed, if I were to say only red stained clay is allowed to go through this pipe, this one is still only able to get red stained clay, because it does not interfere with the logistics firewall at all to actually get the red stained clay out. But this one is able to, should be able to, I should say. Why shouldn't it get it? Oops, yep, there we go. I had to make sure that providing is actually set to allowed, as the request logistics pipes actually counts as providing items too, in combination with the filtered items. So again, as you can see, this one is only allowed to get the red stained clay, but this request logistics pipe can get both the red stained clay and the yellow clay. Because, of course, just imagine if you were to request the items. If I were to request red, of course, it can go through here. If I were to request orange, it cannot go through here because I did not configure the orange color. And this one, on the other hand, it can of course get the orange because it's already on the same side, but it can also get the red because I specified the firewall to allow it. Pretty useful. And of course you can also do this the other way around, just so you can actually restrict the items that are allowed to be either sent or requested, or do whatever you want on a specific side of your network. Pretty useful. Then on this side, I want to show you guys how it actually works with a crafting table. Because as you can see, this thing also has a crafting allowed button. So if I were to say filtered items are blocked, pretty much meaning that everything is allowed, providing allowed, and crafting is allowed, you can see that both crafting and the supplying pipe are allowed to be requested. So, as you can see, I got myself a stack of cobblestone in this crystal chest, and I configured this furnace to be a... or this crafting table to craft a furnace for me on the request. So, what I can do is just, let's say, request a furnace. It has no issues whatsoever. If I were to set to crafting blocked, as you can see, I am still able to actually get the cobblestone out, but I no longer have a visual on the actual crafting table, even though this thing is set to also show crafting. As you can see, if I set it to crafting only, it's simply a blank page. Now, this is also again where it gets a little bit tricky. If I were to set it to crafting allowed, but set filtered items to be blocked, as you can see, nothing will be allowed to go through. Why? Because, of course, as the name would suggest, filtered items are allowed nothing. That means no item is allowed to travel through here. Unless I specify myself filter for a furnace. Then you can see it is only allowed to craft the furnace. Or if I were to put a furnace in here, of course, it would be allowed to get one. But I'm no longer allowed to actually take the raw cobblestone out. Again, this has quite some potential in your actual world if you only want yourself or other players on your server or world to be allowed to get a specific amount of items from your network. For example, only craftable items. Pretty cool. And then of course there's also sorting, which is if you were to use something like a crit sort module to automatically put items in a specific place. If you were to set this to blocked, it would not allow the items to pass through this and be sent to the appropriate location. And with that, guys, I think it would be a good wrapping up point for this episode. I definitely hope you guys found it very educational and most likely also a bit entertaining. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. Like always, try to respond to it as soon as possible and to as many as possible, because of course this is a series for not just me, but also for you guys. So thanks for watching, guys, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.